Hello, everybody. Hope you're doing marvellously well. I'm sitting here in Spitfire Studio, and if you look behind me, there's something different. Yes, I feel a little excited. So about a week ago, I took delivery of these speakers, and I'm trying them out to own. As you know, we recently tested some Focals, maybe like a month or two ago, and the thing that I enjoyed about them, even after using some correctional software, was that the high end was really, really super smooth. So when I went back and asked them, how come your high end, even like super like flat, still sounds smoother than a comparable speaker super flat? They said to me, it's got a lot to do with, and I'm looking here, because sometimes I need notes. It is a, pronounce it properly, a beryllium. Yes, a beryllium tweeter. Now, we have these speakers. They're not cheap. They're powered. They are really kind of smart. I've spent the whole week using them. And last night, we were cranking all kinds of amazing music through it. And I've had a wonderful time on them. So, not only are they really good sounding speakers, they have a really wonderful extra attribute which makes them incredibly useful. We'll get to that in a second. Let me tell you a little bit about them. They're made by, yes, you guessed it. You can see by the Focal logo, they're made by Focal. They're called Trio 11Bs, B-E. They're a three-way active monitor. What does that mean? Simply put, you just plug them in. They have a power amp inside them. I love working on these. Okay, there's a number of reasons. Well, first of all, let's talk a little bit of technical for those that understand this stuff. So they have a 10-inch sub, and if you look to the outside, you'll see that they're ported there, but they're also ported around a 5-inch mid-range, and then, of course, above that is the infamous beryllium inverted dome tweeter. One of the things I like to do is listen and use equipment. And to me, that is far more important than a lot of the scientific ways of doing things. All I can tell you is in this room, I have used Genelex 1032s and I've loved them for years. NS10s, had those for years. The Kallies, which as you know, I love for the value for money. Great reviews all around, incredibly inexpensive. Then I've had the Focals, the newer Focals, which we've been loving because frankly, with the tweeters they use, they're not fatiguing. And when you've been working like I have in the music industry for like 20, nearly 30 years, you want to enjoy the listening experience. You want the detail. You want to be able to mix really, really well on them. But you also don't want to be fatigued after about 3 hours. And that was always the complaint with NS10s. Hence the sort of, I knew some guys, and I won't use their names, that absolutely hated NS10s. But then there was guys like me that grew up using NS10s and loved the aggression, loved hearing the way that a snare sounded, loved the way that a guitar sounded. When you knew that they were offensive, they were great. Now, frankly, I want accuracy and I want unfatiguing. And that's why we're trying these out. So I'm gonna give them a listen. Now here on Produce Like a Pro, you know I pride myself on trying to show all kinds of cross-sections of things. We have championed inexpensive equipment all the way up to expensive. This is probably, well, definitely the most expensive pair of speakers we've ever tried. And for me, over the last few days of using them, they do live up to the, there's no hype because they just came out. They came out today, the day this came out. But I've been really, really enjoying this. And for me, it's really exciting to be able to reference these kind of things. Now, don't get me wrong, we've done iLouds. We've even, when they did a sale on them, we even sent an email to all of our customers because they were selling them at half the price. We have done the Kallies, which we love, which are super inexpensive and have been really good. For me, balance, and just to be able to show something as expensive as this, that might be for guys like me in these kind of environments, something to have, I think is really important to show as well. So let's have a little bit of fun and listen to something really beautiful and definitely not $50. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose music on Spotify. Yes, we'll have that 5-hour discussion about Spotify and Tidal. No, but I'm going to choose music on Spotify, easily accessible, that I recorded and mixed in this room, especially stuff I mixed in this room. Often, obviously, I'll go to Sunset Sound or some of my old studios that I've worked in and track, but tons and tons of stuff I've mixed here. Now, it does mean they're going to run ads on the front of this video, by the way, that have got nothing to do with me, and we may even get flagged, but what the heck, you know what I mean? I've got to do this. So, one of the albums that I'm very proud of and I like the sound of is, and not huge selling, well, you know, fairly good, fairly well selling, is Trevor Hall. Trevor's very, very talented, and what I like about this is, and this will please the purists, is there are no drum samples, there's no heavy editing, it's a completely performance-based album. And this song, it's pretty good, Green Mountain State, it has 22 and a half million plays. And it was recorded using the Ludwig drums in there. Trevor played all the instruments, so he'd go around and play drums, he'd play some guitar, I played some electric, but he mainly played everything, piano, sang. It was fantastic. But why I love this song is the floor tom. And you will not obviously be able to hear it through our little lapel mic, but there's something really, really fun about these speakers. I'm going to get into it. So let's listen.
The Green Mountain State. I call to the silence you make. Do you
the low end is absolutely phenomenal on them because I'm turning on the 10-inch sub. But not only am I turning on the 10-inch sub, I've got this porting in it. Look, I'm no expert. I'm sure there's plenty of experts here to tell me I'm wrong. That's okay. But I'm listening, if I turn that there, and you'll see this green light comes on. This is just a 5-inch with a beryllium, which frankly sounds, not gonna say it is because that's wrong, but it's gonna be like emulating something a lot closer to like an NS10 or a smaller mid-range. And it actually sounds fantastic.
It has always.
I mean, there's some good thump there. It's powerful, but come down here, turn this on.
In the house way down.
It's got stand-up bass in it. We'll put a link to the track so you can hear what I'm hearing and understand what I'm talking about, of course. But this is a very, very organic song. It was recorded in that room and mixed here. So I know how this sounds. Okay, so that was Trevor. That was organic. That was recorded in this room. The low end on the tom, the floor tom is absolutely phenomenal. I love the focus of the 5-inch. I like the fact when I'm listening to the 5-inches, I still hear the kick. I still hear it thumping. They've managed to make this sound like small speakers, which is what it is. But I don't feel like I'm being thrown into a world where it's so different and it confuses the schnizzle out of me. That, I think, is also smart. This could be the future. They may well be the first of many people doing the same thing. Or there may have been other people that did it, but just not as well. What do I know? All right, I'm going to go and pick some Aerosmith. Now, I did the last album with them, and I mixed half of the album. Neil Avron mixed half, the other half of the album. And the five songs that I mixed, or six, I don't remember, were done here, in this room, on this gear, everything the same. And so I want to listen to a couple of things I did. This first song here, Love Three Times, is like really crazy song. The drums are a metal drum kit that was in the warehouse. And it's really kind of synthetic sounding. Yeah, and it's got a very, very different sound. All right, why did I do that? Well, first of all, because it sounds great. But you hear this tom fill, it's very directional because it goes da do da 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 do do da do do, and it plays the toms with barely anything else there. So it's really great. First of all, I hear the width going from left and right, but the low end on the toms is phenomenal. So that's on the little ones. I'm going to do the same thing. I just went from two different things. So I went bigs to little. Now I'm going to go back to the bigs. The bigs. I'm going to go back to the 10-inch sub on with them.
To enter a great adventure.
It's Jack Douglas doing the speaking here.
From your ultimate
he does in the left and the right, and we panned opposite. Not many people got the obvious joke, but we did. Nice. You had this hello and goodbye line, and the song starts off hello and then does goodbyes. And so we actually had Julian Lennon sing on it, which was rather fun, seeing as it was a Beatles reference. Okay, so really fantastic. Love both of the versions there. Let's move on. So that was tracked at my old studio. Let us go and choose something else. I'm going to go to some of David's music, who is standing behind here. Are you happy to do this, David? Okay, good. I have to check. Now, we have done a whole bunch of stuff together over the years, and one of those things that I love is that we've done songs online that you probably are quite aware of that you can download actually multi-tracks on. The last single that we did fairly recently was called Fortunes. Let's check that out. Now, Fortunes is just he and I playing all the instruments. He's playing the drums. I don't think there's any piano. If there's piano, he played the piano. He usually, not always, but 99% of the time, plays the acoustic. A couple of times I've played it, and then I usually do bass and electric. So we split up the duties fairly evenly, with him being infinitely better drummer than I'll ever be. But this is me doing my best Tim Pierce guitar solo impersonation. What I liked about this song is I didn't mix a whole lot of high mid or articulation on the bass because I wanted it to be almost country. The song is not country, but you know, with the shuffle pattern on the drums, it gives us a very, very different thing to listen to. Intermittent kick drum, no hole on the kick. So I really feel that oomph coming from the 10-inch. Really feel it.
Time. When all the flashing lights felt like blessings.
Really good. Okay, going to the 5-inch and the beryllium only.
And now I shield my eyes.
You still, I know you can't hear it for the small mic, but trust me, you can still hear the articulation on the bass. It's great. So now it's bringing out kind of the boom, boom, but in that mid-range. You know, the low mids. And then I go to bring in the sub and I get the super low lows. What a really smart idea.
Oh, the quiet nights drifting undisguised.
Really good. Really, really good. Okay, so now I'm going to change and we're going to go to another one of David's songs, but we'll go something really, really dense. Let's go to City Lights, which is a song he and I did with some world-class musicians, some incredible musicians. But we also did this at Sunset Sound, and a lot of it is live off the floor. So it's live bass, live drums, live guitars, and I think piano. Yeah, and live Steinway. So David was playing piano live, bass live was... Was it John Button or was it Dan Rothschild?
Sean Hurley.
Oh, Sean Hurley, of course. Yes, Sean Hurley. The very great Sean Hurley on bass. Drums, was it Victor and Drizzle or Blair Sinter? Blair Sinter. Again, you hear that low on that kick, but also that floor tom going to the 5-inch. Now, I'm not doing this as pure vanity. I'm listening to music. I know how it sounds in this room because I mixed it in this room. I can't think of a better way of experiencing this. Because Because I could go and listen to the greatest recording of the greatest engineer in the entire world, and it would sound fantastic, and it wouldn't show me anything. This, I know these songs intimately, and it's really great. I'm not gonna follow. It's amazing that even on this fives, the amount of lows that I'm getting, but as soon as you go to here and put the 10-inch sub in, wow. It's just really enjoyable and really detailed. Yep. Okay, fantastic stuff. Okay, we're gonna go around the back now and check out all the bits and pieces that are on there. Now, the way that this works with the foot switch is it plugs into the back and then there's a tie line cable from either one of the speakers. You can come into either one. With us, it was just easier because the way to get in the back behind our console is from the right-hand side of the console. So obviously it was easier to plug it in there. But for other people, it might be equal or it might only be from the left. So you can plug in and then daisy chain, tie lane, whatever you want to say, over to the other speaker. So that's great. So by controlling that, you'll see the green lights come on both speakers. So that when the green light on the Focus is on, it's on only the 5-inch and the Beryllium tweeter. When you take it off, it's on normal mode and it's got the 10-inch sub with the other two components, making it a three-way speaker, which is fantastic. Let's see what else is on the back of the speaker. So there's a power cable in there, obviously, and then there's the on-off switch next to it. So if we go to the top, there's enable, disable function here. So they turn themselves off. So you don't have to have them enabled. You can leave them on the whole time. Okay, so next to that is obviously the XLR input, which is balanced. But what I like here is you've got +4 for a professional use, like I'm using here, coming from a console. Or of course, you can have -10. So on the back of here, we've got these three controls here. We've got it all set flat, so we can just hear it in the room. I didn't mess with it. I didn't feel like I needed to add any more high frequency. Here on each of these, the low, the mid, and the high, you've got ±3 dB. So you really could shape these if you wanted. So in the three-way mode, that's the 10-inch, the 5-inch, and the Beryllium, it's got a 30 hertz to a 40 kilohertz response. It says ±3 dB, so it's pretty honest. I like that. So 30 hertz to 40 kilohertz. That's pretty fantastic. And then in the two-way mode, which they call the Focus mode, that's the 5-inch with the Beryllium tweeter, it's 90 to 20, again, ±3 dB, which is probably why I thought the kick was sounding about 80 or 90 hertz, because it would have been 90 hertz. Okay, the maximum SPL, sound pressure level, the three-way mode is 118 dB, which is easily enough to deafen most people. The two-way mode is 105 dB. Well, I hope you enjoyed that a lot. I did. I am going to be leaving these up for a while. We're teaching a masterclass next week during this whole NAMM thing. We're going to be doing a lot of filming from NAMM. This, of course, is the first day of NAMM, and this pair of speakers is being announced and released today. So thank you ever so much, Focal, for letting me try before you buy first. So I think that's pretty phenomenal. I really, really appreciate it. I think the whole Beryllium tweeter thing is something that I have a lot of conversation about. So I'm really excited to have this in another pair of speakers and really kind of experience it. But I think in general, this idea of moving between the 5-inch without the 10-inch subwoofer and then having it with the 10-inch subwoofer is fantastic. I've been using them the last few days with the full range. Only recently have I been going down to the smaller one. So I've been working on a speaker with a better extended low end than I'm used to with my current speakers. That was pretty phenomenal to hear that. And very pleasing when I was able to do what you saw me do, which was listen to music I have mixed myself in this room. I can't think of a better way of really understanding how your music sounds than listening to your own music that you've mixed on other speakers in a room that you know. And there is no room in the world I know better than this room. So I hope that helps. I hope we gave you enough technical stuff. You know me, I tend to talk a lot about feel and emotion, and I mix that way and I think that way. You know, I'm a musician first, I'm a guitar player and a songwriter. Then I turned into other instruments and became an engineer and a producer and a mixer. So that's my journey. So I always work from that. I always come from a musicality, and then the technical is something, you know, if I don't like something or I do like something, then I look to find out why. Then I go, what is it? And then I might see a technical problem. But if I don't hear a technical problem, then I'm not going to be looking for it. And these, for me, have a lovely low extended bass. And when I was listening to music over the last few days just for pure enjoyment, I loved it. Listening to other people's mixes was phenomenal. Listening to my own and hearing that extra little bit of low end that I added to Trevor Hall and hearing it translate without the need of a big sub was fantastic. The only other time I've heard it sound that good is in a mastering studio. And so that is a really, really wonderful thing. Anyway, they're not cheap, but then again, you know, the kind of people that will be looking at this will be looking at it for exactly the same purpose of me. Is there a pair of speakers that you could have up there mainly, and then have other small ones maybe for different references, but something that will do all of the jobs. Do something that I can mix on 90% of the time and then, you know, check on with the smaller speakers. I think they will be. It's early days, but so far, so good. I'm really, really loving them. Have a marvelous time recording and mixing. Thank you ever so much for watching. And I'll speak to you all again soon. Please leave a bunch of comments and questions below if you have any experiences with other Focal products, you know, or other speakers. What are the speakers that you love to use? Have you tried this kind of technology before? Please let us know. Have a marvelous time recording and mixing, and I'll see you all again very, very soon.